Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today is a very special day. Right here, I have my Spider-Man Homecoming suit that I ordered off a print costume. I've been waiting for a while for this suit to come, and I'm really happy that it's finally here. We're gonna unbox this, I'm gonna put it on, I'm gonna give you my honest review and opinion on the suit, so let's get right into it.
Alright, so real quickly before we get into the video, I'm going to be telling you guys all the specs I got on my suit, all the options I ordered, in case you guys were wondering, so you guys know exactly all the options I got. So first off, I got it custom tailored to my size, so I put in all my measurements. It's pretty simple to measure yourself, in case you guys were wondering. I got it with attached lenses, and I got it with the thick color fabrics. Definitely recommend. I got it with soles attached, and I put in my shoe size.
And for the zipper, I got a U-shaped zipper in the back.
Then I got the leather details added, and I got a detached mask with a forearm zipper, and I got it with open eye holes. And then I got the raised spider emblems. I definitely recommend getting that. It's amazing.
All right, without further ado, let's unbag this.
All right, guys, so here we have the package itself. We're going to cut this open here. I don't want to flip it over because it has, like, my address and stuff on it. So it comes in another bag. So here is the original bag, and there's another one. This one does not have my billing address on it, so I can show it. But it comes in the DHL bag. That's where I got it. That's the company that shipped it to me. Don't want to cut the suit here. Alright, so as you guys can see, it comes in this nice bag. Whew, this is looking good, guys. Here it is. It says right here, print costume, dedication to replication costumes, props for your cosplay. Alright, so I can feel that spider on there, man. This feels amazing. This feels absolutely amazing. So we're gonna open this nice bag here. I don't wanna like wreck this. I'm gonna peel it off very nicely. Okay, you know what, whatever. We're just ripping it like that. So the bag opens like this. And inside we have the Spider-Man Homecoming suit. Here's the back spider. It's rubber, as you can tell. That looks really nice. We're just gonna open this bag here. Oh, look at that leathering detail on it. Oh my god. Oh god. Alright, so if we pull the costume out here. I got this with soles, like I mentioned. So, okay. Here's the unfolding of it. Alright guys, so here's the suit. As you can see, we have that 3D rubber spider on the front. That looks absolutely amazing. These colors look great, guys. Like, I got it on colored fabrics. It costed an extra, like, $15 Canadian. I think it was, like, $10 American. But I got colored fabrics. I do recommend it. This looks absolutely amazing. So, as you guys can see here, here's the wrist. I ordered wrist zippers, like I told you. So, this is what those look like. I don't know if you can see it very well. I don't know if I have the camera set up good, but here's that rubber spider. That looks amazing. Here's that pack spider. Woohoo! As you can see, it has the lines just like the movie, which is actually really cool. It doesn't have, like, the texture that it does in the movie, but obviously they're not going to put that on there. That's very difficult to do. But it does have those lines that are in the movie. So, as you can see, all the leather around here. And that just looks absolutely amazing, guys. We got the tech lines on the things here. Here we have soles. I ordered my costume with soles, so it's like basically like this water shoe material. There we have that. Here are both of them. And basically what we're gonna do is gonna have a full body shot of the suit now, and then I'm gonna put it on. Alright guys, real quickly, I know you guys are waiting, sorry, but I just wanted you guys to see the mask. I did not review when I was unboxing it, and here's what it looks like. It's absolutely amazing. It's detached with attached lenses, and it's like sewn right here. So it's really nice. The lenses are like 100% movie accurate. They look really good. They don't look the best like when the mask is off, but that's obviously because the mask is off. But here's a quick view of what it looks like on. I gotta pull it down. Probably looks bad right now. But like with the mask on, it does look pretty good. I'll show you guys after I show you the full body shot of the suit. I'll put on the suit and then show you guys what the mask looks like with the suit on, but this is what it looks like. You can see my ears there, but that is movie accurate. It's in the movie. They CGI'd
The CGI makes it look like you can see his ears, but this is without a face shell. I may get a face shell in the future. I don't know. They are expensive, so that's why I was debating whether I should get one or not. But I got attached lenses, and I'm actually very pleasantly surprised because these are so much better than I thought they were going to be. I thought they were going to be, like, scrunched up in the middle and not be movie accurate. Like, they just, they Print Costumes did the best. Thank you guys, Print Costumes. Definitely go check out their website. But, yeah, pulling it off is a little tricky, as, like, it is a tight mask, but it's perfectly fine. Like, up here, it's like, a little loose, which is good. Like, room to grow, like I said. But, like, down, putting the mask on, actually, it's obviously able to stretch, but it is pretty tight because it has to go tight around your neck. But, the mask is amazing. Now, I'll show you guys the suit. All right, guys, so here's a full body shot of what the suit looks like. It looks absolutely amazing. So, what we're going to go over here is all the leather detailing going all around. It's really nice. Here are the soles, which I just showed you guys, but I just wanted to show you guys again. They did the leather even all the way down here, so I really like that. Like, they got it so movie accurate. The blue is a little bit lighter in the movie, but I'm someone who doesn't really care about that, but just, like, if you get colored fabrics, then just keep that in mind. I personally don't care about it, but you guys might. So here are the hands. They fit perfect on my hand. There's a little bit of room, which is perfect for me to grow. So also the soles, they also fit me good. They're a little big, and I ordered them big, so they delivered what I asked for. And here's the neck. When you actually put it on yourself, it's like, it's pretty high. Like, it's like a really big, long turtleneck, which isn't too movie accurate, but, like, it's fine. I personally don't care, but, like, you might. It's so you can actually tuck in the mask. So here's that front spider. I already showed that. I'll show it when I put the suit on. It's, like, absolutely amazing. So now we'll take a quick look at the back. Here is where the back spider is, obviously. It's even got the leather here. This looks absolutely amazing. But under the arms here should be the zippers. And as you can see, we got the U-shaped zipper. And that reveals that it is printed on colored fabrics. If you guys don't know what colored fabric means, it basically just means that all the colors are printed on, so say the red is printed on red fabrics, as you can see, and the blue is printed on blue. So basically this provides, first off, the colors just look way more vibrant and just, like, solid. They're just, like, so much better. And also, say if you get the basic fabric option, which isn't bad, like, it's just, like, what your suit is normally printed on, but with colored fabrics, you stretch the fabric out, there's no fading. Like, it doesn't turn white. So that's what I really like about colored fabrics. Now, if you get regular suit after, like, wearing it out for a while, it does stretch out and it does fade a little bit white. It's not horrible, but, like, colored fabrics is so much better. At first, I wasn't so sure about this leather right here, right by the wrist zipper. But now that I've looked at photos, it actually is really movie accurate, because in the movie, he has this little line here, and then he has his web shooters right on the wrist. So I'm assuming there's just, like, black underneath the web shooters when he doesn't have his web shooters on. But there is actually this line, like, in the movie. It's just his web shooters over most of it. But yeah, that's basically the suit, guys. Here's, like, a quick view at, like, the what do you call them? The boots, like the socks. Here's what they look like with the soles. And yeah, the blue, like, on the pants looks really nice. It has all the Stark tech lines. That's amazing. So yeah, we're gonna get in with this U-shaped zipper. Let's go. Costume did this suit. It fits me perfect, and it's a little loose on places, which is good because I am a growing boy. I will be growing. It looks and feels absolutely amazing. It's just like a perfect fit. I do have a little bit of room in spots, but here are where the two zippers, or the U-shaped zipper, meets right here. And anyway, just look at that leather strapping detail. It looks absolutely amazing. The mask does scrunch up a little bit in the middle there. You just gotta pull it apart, but that's the suit with the mask on. I'm going to take this off because it does get a little bit hard to breathe. But just so you guys know, the lenses do not fog up. But after a while, it does get a little hot in there. But The lenses do not fog up. As I was saying, here's the, like, long neck seam. Now, it doesn't look bad, in my opinion, but, like, it is, like, a little, like, longer than it is in the movie. Here's a photo of what it looks like in the movie. Like, compared to that, it does look a little long, you know what I mean? The spider, though. Here's the front spider. Here's what the front spider looks like. As you can see, that's absolutely amazing. Like, I feel like just like Spider-Man. Like, I feel like Tom Holland, bro. Here's the leather detailing all around the suit. Here's the back, guys. Now, I know you guys can't see my legs. I'm going to show that in a second. But, like, this suit just looks absolutely amazing. You can't capture the essence of this on video. Like, it's seriously, like, it looks so much better in person than you guys are watching this video. It's got the web belt here. It's really nice. I'm going to add web cartridges. Currently, I am, like, 99% done the process of these web shooters. I just need to add Velcro, and that's it. But these are my homemade web shooters. A video coming out on those soon, I guess. I would put them on with the suit, but I actually can't. Like I said, no Velcro on them, but I made these myself. They're pretty cool. I'll quickly show you guys what it would, like, look like with it on. Probably looks pretty good. So anyway, that is the top part. It looks absolutely amazing. Like, it's just, like, really good, guys. All right, guys, so here's, like, down lower. Here's, like, the web belt in the back right here. I'm going to cover up my butt. That's weird. There's, like, a little webbing design right there. That looks really good. If we move down lower, you guys can see the soles are on me right now. They feel and look absolutely amazing. Like I said, there's a little bit of room here. That's because I got them a little big. Got them half a size big so I can grow into them. But they're pretty nice. The tread is really cool. Like, I love the way it looks. I don't know if I can... There's the tread. It looks absolutely amazing. But I really, really like this part right here. Like, how they got the leather down here. And this part's, like, really skin tight. So it just looks, like, amazing right here. Like, this... Just, like, the socks look great. Soles look amazing, too. Basically, that's, like, the lower part. The blues look really nice here, the tech lines here. As you can see, I don't know if you can see that actually. There's the U-shaped zipper right here. But you can't, like, it's supposed to be invisible, but, like, since it's, like, blue, you can see a little bit on the red. But I don't really care. It still looks great. Here are the hands. Like I said about this leather, I think I already said that. I'm not gonna say it again, but, like, here are the hands. And like I said, they fit me, like, perfectly, basically. They're a little loose right here, which is good. I'm going to get bigger hands over time. But, yeah, here's the suit. This looks great. It looks absolutely amazing. Like, it just, like, it feels great, too. I don't know if I'm going to puff paint this. I got all the stuff for puff painting. I'm probably going to do, like, the dotted red texture along it. I got all the stuff for puff painting, but I don't know if I'm going to do it. Because, like, this suit just looks absolutely amazing, and I don't want to ruin it. If I do that, I will do a video on that, but I won't do that for a while. I'm just showing off the suit a little bit more. It looks absolutely amazing, like those shoulder straps. And the mask looks great, too. Let me just show you guys that one more time. And here's what I see through the mask. Here's what I see. I can't, like, put it on there good, but here's the sight out of the mask. It's pretty good. All right, so that's basically the suit. Now I'm going to give you my review on the whole suit, pros and cons. There's, spoiler alert, there's not many cons with this suit. It's amazing. Like, it's just great. Love the leather straps. So worth the money. So yeah. Alright, so now that you guys have seen the suit on me, I'm going to give a full in-depth review, my opinion on what I think of this suit. Alright, so first off, thank you, Zentai, or Print Costume. Zentai Zone is basically the same brand. If you guys didn't know, there was originally a website called Zentai Zone. And recently, just a couple months ago, they split their website into two different websites. So there's Zentai Zone and then there's Print Costume, which Print Costume, as you guys know, is the website I got my suit off of. That's like all the superhero and Spider-Man stuff, you know. And then Zentai Zone is more for weird stuff. You can see the zippers a little bit here. Here's the wrist zippers in case you guys were wondering. I can slip my hands out pretty easily, like if you wanted to use your phone or something while in the suit, you can just slip your hands out pretty easily. You gotta, like, pull the fingers and then just pull back and slip through. And you could, like, wear this underneath your clothes and, like, hide the hands. The feet will be showing unless you get no soles, and, like, you can put, like it's just, like, the sock part, and you can, like, put shoes over top of it. but that's only if you get no soles or kung fu shoes. Anyway, I'm going to give my review on the suit. Alright, so like I said, great job print costumes. It's absolutely amazing. I'm really happy with the way this suit turned out. There's like basically no cons with this suit. Like, there's just the tiniest little things. But I'm going to tell you guys the things I love the most. Everything. I love this front spider. Like, that just looks so good. Like, it doesn't even look as good as it does in real life on camera. The back spider also looks amazing. Like, that just looks so great. Just amazing. Wrist zippers, I'm glad I got these. They're really cool. One thing, though, I could have got ankle zippers. It's just, like, a zipper right here, and I probably should have got those. They were a little bit more money, but, like, getting these soles on is probably the hardest part of this suit. It may look easy. Like, it may look like you can just slip your feet in there, but, like, unless you're wearing socks, which I don't know why socks make it easier. Don't ask me why, but I am wearing socks right now, and it's just, like, so much easier. But, like, still, it's a tricky thing to get the sole on, so that's why I should have got ankle zippers. All right, so, like, I love everything with the suit. I love the leather. I love the colors. It's just, like, the thick color fabrics is awesome. Super happy with the soles. One thing, though, like I mentioned, if you guys were wanting a movie-accurate colors, maybe don't get the colored fabrics. It's your choice. It's a little dark in the movie. I really don't care. So, like, the slightest little bit. I don't know if I said darker or lighter. It's lighter in the movie is what I meant to say. In case you guys are wanting, like, 100% movie-accurate, maybe don't get the thick color fabrics because it is a little darker, but I personally don't care too much. If you guys are ordering a suit, the one thing I should have got ankle zippers, but also, you guys, if you guys are getting a face shell, which I don't, this isn't like a complaint for me, I'm just saying you guys should get a zippered mask. It makes it 100 million times easier. Like, just zip it and put the face shell in, put it on your face. The one thing that I regret is when I ordered the suit, I should have got like a little, like the slightest bit bigger. I did get it half a size big, so it's like perfect right now. Putting the waist on, it's like a little bit tight, so that's like the only part on the suit that like I find like tight at all. Like, literally, it's obviously a tight suit, it's a spandex, but like, I mean, like, the whole thing is perfect, and so is the waist right now, but I'm talking in the future, it's gonna be a little tricky to get on, but I think it's still gonna be fine. It's just like a little tight pulling the legs up past my waist. I have to like slip and slide on the dance floor. Let's go, lose control, slip and slide on the dance floor. Let's go, lose control. 3, 2, 1, drop it. Bum 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 bum. Alright guys, so I 100% recommend this website, Print Costume. Go and order a suit off of there. In case you guys were wondering, I'm going to give you the final total of the suit. In Canadian dollars, this Spider-Man costume, with every single option that I have on here, it costed me $219. So it's not like, it's like pretty expensive, but like, I'm definitely happy with the way I spent my money. I saved up my money to get this, and I'm pretty glad because it's absolutely amazing. I love how they got that, the lines on the spider there. I love everything about it. There's basically, like, no cons. Like, this little friggin' thing. Like I said, it's just this little friggin' thing, and the waist is a little tight. That's completely it. Like, that, those are my only two things I don't like about the suit. It's great, guys. I'm definitely not hating on this suit. Oh, totally worth the money. One more time, if you guys are wondering, I'll put it on the mask. You gotta, like, it takes a second to actually, like, put on. You can't be as quick as Spidey, especially putting the suit on. It's like really, really long process to put the suit on. It's like 2.5 minutes, which isn't like too long, but like 2.5 minutes to put on a Spider-Man costume. It's a little long, but like I said, should have got ankle zippers. I don't really care though. It still is amazing. But so basically, that is the video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys later. Definitely recommend Print Costumes to get yourself your Spider-Man costume. I'll see you guys later. Peace.